Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1676, VLOOKUP into a range of zip codes. Oh boy, today's question is sent in by Heather. Heather wants to know if I could maybe knock out some VBA. She has zip codes, postal codes, for those of you not in the United States, where they show the range, right? So Barry gets all postal codes from 04948 to 07371. And here we have some zip codes. We need to figure out who the rep is. All right, so for 22820, well, that would be Ollie. But we don't want to have to like do this, you know, manually and type them all in. We want to do a VLOOKUP or something like that. All right, so this is pretty wild. Equal match. I want to go look for this zip code value in a range of just the leftmost 5 characters of column A. So what we're going to do is we're going to say 1 plus left of this range, I'll press F4 to lock that down, comma 5. So what we're going to get is 00001 as text, but when I add 1 to that, it's going to convert it to a number. Oh wait, it should be 0. 0 plus the left. Alright, so that way we get just the leftmost characters, and what that's going to give us, provided this is sorted over here, is the starting zip code for Larry, and then the starting zip code for Debbie, the starting zip code for Debbie. Oh, that's funny, why did they do that? Who knows? Okay, and then what do we want? We want the value just less than, which is the same as doing true in a VLOOKUP. Now, because this is returning a range, an array of values, we have to press Control Shift Enter here, and I actually held my breath when I did that the first time, and sure enough, it's returning the 11th row in the range. That's beautiful. Now all we have to do is use the index function of these names here in B2 to B44. I'll press F4 to lock that down, comma, which row do we want? It's the answer from the match. We don't need to specify which column since it's a single column, and then Control Shift Enter gets us Ollie. Double click to shoot that down. All right, now you'll see here this zip code up in New England is stored without the leading zero. The proper thing to do is to store these as numbers and then use the custom number format. Actually, there's a special number format in the US of zip code, which is really a custom number format of 5 zeros. Click OK and click OK. Well, now that'll be great, but sometimes people will store these numbers as text, and that's going to cause a problem over here. If you have numbers stored as text, you're going to want to convert them back to numbers, just equal to text plus 0 or times 1 to convert those back to regular numbers, and use that inside of the match. So instead of D3, you'll do D3 plus 0 if these are actually stored as text. Now all of this, Heather, assumes that the people have actually used 5-digit zip codes and they haven't shortened it like 073 through 078. If they've done that, it's going to become much, much harder. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time. Another net, Mr. Excel.